couldn't find a place to rest until I got that thug life tatted on my chest. Tell me, can you feel me? I'm not living in the past. You wanna laugh? Be the first to blast. Remember Cato? No longer with the seats and seats. Calling the sirens. Seen them murdered in the streets. Now rest in peace. Is there heaven for a G? Remember me? So many homies in the cemetery. Shed so many tears. I took a shot at it. It shed so many tears. Lord, I lost so many tears, shed so many tears. Now that I'm struggling in the distance, by any means, label me greedy, do my thing, and I felt a pain. I think the world is a curse. I'm having visions of even here, and I heard God.
Tupac had it all. Tupac had the Rolls Royce. Tupac had the women. Tupac had everything. But one bullet took it away. If Tupac could come back, he wouldn't sing to you about the thug life. If Tupac could come back, he wouldn't talk to you about a gang or selling dope. He would tell that dope dealer to go back to hell where he came from. He'd tell you, young lady, that he would tell you, young ladies, that losing your virginity isn't worth being popular. About a year ago, my wife and I received a telephone call from Mrs. Evander Holyfield. She had been watching our television program. She invited us to her mansion in Atlanta to have lunch. And what I'm about to tell you, a lot of people don't know, but it's the truth. Just hours before Tupac was shot, and he would die 3 days later, he was shot in a drive-by shooting. Tupac had gone to Las Vegas to see Mike Tyson and Evander Holyfield fight. And just hours before he was shot, Evander Holyfield felt led to talk to Tupac in a private meeting about his soul. Evander said, and he said, Tupac, you know what's right. You know you're living wrong. You know Jesus has made a difference in my life, and you need to give your life to the Lord. And he said, Tupac said, one day, but not right now. I'm having too much fun. I got my whole life ahead of me. I know what's right, but not right now. I want to party. I'm young. I want to have a good time. One day, we'll get back in church. But Python had already planned. Can you hear in that intensive care unit in Las Vegas as the breathing machine is going up and down, and finally Python takes his last squeeze, and Tupac, the superstar, he's gone. If he could come back, I wonder what you
think. Everybody's asking me who shot Tupac. The player fell victim to whose spot. A question I would ask if my homie was around. But somebody put his body 6 feet in the ground. Is there a place for dope dealers in the sky? Is it a room for coke killers that do the drive-by? There I go again, dreaming, scheming, thinking that I'm seeing in a room full of hellfire, brimstone and demons. Tupac is struggling just to stay alive. I'm playing for life, but he was buried at 25. And if it was here, I think it'd make it real clear that your soul won't be playing hearts in the atmosphere. We got a destination, it's God who we're facing. So if you slip up, then have a good explanation. If Tupac came back, he'd have a story to tell. That everybody's going to a heaven or a hell.
Let it go.
Aaliyah, according to her own words on her website, developed her talent in the house of God. She began to sing at an early age the songs of the church. You say, it couldn't happen to me, what's happening to them. It already is, and some of you don't even know it. You're already entangled in stuff. You say, I can control it. The python's stronger than you are. She had made a movie. Her career was on track. She had sold 1 million copies of her record. She had gone to the Bahamas to make a brand new video for her new release. But little did she know she would die at 22 years of age. Do you understand that her movie, even though she's dead, is the number one movie in America as I stand on this platform right now. And you guys know I'm telling you the truth. Prophetically, it was named. She didn't know when she was shooting it that the name of the movie would be a prophecy over her life. Aaliyah, Queen of the Damned.
I don't care about nothing, man. Roll another blunt.
I was gonna clean my room until I got high. I was gonna get up and find the groove, but then I got high.